Hey, what is up, everybody? This is Stevie Breach coming to you here today as we're watching the WWE's Elimination Chamber 2018. I started the show honestly a little bit late. My mom, who was spending some time with me, she came in from Florida. Tonight is the night that she's leaving, and I spent the last bit of time going out to dinner with her, having a few last minute chats before she head off to the airport. So I'm honestly starting this show, it looks like, about 3 hours too late. The first match just ended, honestly, as the pay-per-view is probably started. I'm doing a pretty good job of staying off of social media. I'm able to tweet out my thoughts using my phone, texting them out. But I'm not really looking at what is going down, although I do have one of the matches spoiled for me on accident. I was not able to avoid that one. The beginning of the pay-per-view is exactly starting the way that I thought it was going to, with the Women's Elimination Chamber. I gave this match a little bit of flack. I honestly said that I thought that the women did a really good job for the Royal Rumble. I thought that it was a lot of a better match than I thought it was going to be. I will tell you that I don't think this is the greatest Elimination Chamber of all time. I do think the Elimination Chamber is a hard match to mess up. I do believe that the ECW December to Dismember Elimination Chamber is probably the worst one of all time. A lot of people throw flack at the tag team as well as the Intercontinental one for when they brought back the chamber a few years ago. I honestly liked those matches. I didn't really see anything wrong with them. I think that they stacked the deck with having the New Day in there. But the Chamber's always been a really good match in my mind. And the women went out there. You had six competitors in there. I know that Dana Brooke did a last-minute Twitter push trying to get into the match, but it did not work. And she pretty much got her ass kicked on Monday. I think it was her receipt. For those tweets about, being left out and not noticed. We'll have to see what comes from that. But the match featured Alexa Bliss coming in as women's champion. She was going to be going up against Sasha Banks, Bayley, Mickie James, as well as Sonya Deville with Mandy Rose. The match started out with everybody getting in the pods and Sasha Banks as the first competitor in there with Sonya Deville. This match, honestly, was built on the storyline of friendship and having an ally inside of there. Yes, there are some six competitors, but if you have somebody out there fighting the fight with you, you can go through and you can eliminate the people that you need to eliminate, and then when it comes down to it, you can sort out your problems from there. We had a last-minute, ditch effort by Alexa Bliss. Finding a friend in Mickie James. They have a storyline dating back to Mickie James coming back on the main roster, helping Alexa Bliss to feed off Becky Lynch on SmackDown. Their friendship broke up around WrestleMania last year with the six-pack challenge. But a lot of good stuff, coming from this match. Sonya Deville, led by Paige, coming out with Mandy Rose. Of course, they're going to fight with each other. And Bayley and Sasha Banks, friends for life, going back to the days of training at the Performance Center, coming up through NXT, even though they had the on-screen rivalry there. The second they've hit the main roster, they've always gone with it. They were friends for life, and even though they were in the storylines together with NXT, that they stick together and they sort of throw that rivalry out. They like to bring up that match, but they don't really have a payoff for those matches happening with them still being friends. I really think a lot like with Corey Graves was thinking. We all were waiting for a part in the match for when Sasha Banks was going to turn on Bayley. I think everybody saw that coming. I'm not sure if there's room on the WrestleMania card, even if it is a 7-hour show, to have Bayley go up against Sasha, but I think that is a match that people would want to see. I'm going to hate to see if it gets relegated to the pre-show when those are two really, really good workers. And Sasha Banks at WrestleMania 32 as well as WrestleMania 33 has had really, really good matches and really knocked it out of the park. But, you know, there's only so much time, and you know that Ronda Rousey's going to get it, Asuka's going to get it, and I don't really know where else people are going to be fitting in on there. This was a really good, match. It all started with Absolution taking the numbers game in there. Sasha Banks had to fight off Sonya Deville as well as Mandy Rose. But during that time, we were able to get an elimination with Mandy Rose tapping out to the Banks statement. From there, we had Bayley join into the match, followed by Mickey James, and then last but not least was Alexa Bliss. During the match, before Alexa Bliss got in there, basically we had Mickey James on the run, trying to get away from Sasha, as well as Sonya Deville and Bayley. Mickey James climbed up the cell. It was the chamber, whatever you want to call it. It was sort of a piece of the story to go along with the match. That once she got up there, she jumped off the top of one of the chamber pods, taking out Sonya Deville for her to get the win. But then momentarily after that, I think it was Mickey James getting hit with a belly to Bayley, and then being pinned by Bayley to get her eliminated. At this point, that is when Alexa Bliss, who had not been released from her pod yet, noticed that she was going to be released in there, and there was nothing to save her from Bayley as well as Sasha Banks. 2-on-1, her knowing that she didn't have anybody to help her. Once she was put into the chamber, she climbed to the top of the chamber trying to escape. And honestly, to me, I understand what they were doing, but it really, really stopped the match and really put it on ice. And they had so many fast eliminations, it was really starting to pick up the pace. And then out of the middle of nowhere, as Sasha Banks was beating up Alexa Bliss on top of one of the chamber pods, we had Sasha Banks kick Bayley, making her fall from the top of the chamber pod. That, I guess, starting the Sasha Banks versus Bayley feud. This is the second pay-per-view in a row. We're going back to the Royal Rumble, where basically Sasha has thrown out the friendship and just gone in the direction of, you know, she wants the championship and she's going to have to do what she wants to and to get it. And friendship goes out the window at that point. I understand why she did what she did, but that basically turned it into a regular match with not the 2-on-1 atmosphere. In the end, it was Alexa Bliss fighting with Sasha Banks. Basically, Sasha was climbing up to the top of the chamber to jump off one of the chamber pods, trying to gain the advantage to win the championship from Alexa. But Alexa was able to catch up with her, and from the top rope of the actual ring, we had her hit a huge DDT covering Sasha Banks for the 1-2-3. Once Renee Young came into the ring for the post-match interview, we had a really big interview with Alexa Bliss where she broke down crying, the crowd chanting, "You deserve it." Her basically going into the whole spiel, she didn't talk about her eating disorder, but I thought that's the avenue that they were going down, where, you know, you can dream big and achieve any of your dreams. And the second I was wondering, you know, if she's going to be fighting against Asuka at WrestleMania, why are they going with this Barbie doll sort of babyface ordeal? You know, Alexa should be, you know, being the heel that she's always been. Immediately slams the door on everybody, saying that they will never be able to achieve their dreams and that she is one of the greatest women's champions of all time. You know, a really good match. It's not going to go down as one of the best chambers, but it's going to be remembered as one of the first for the women. Right now we have the Bar going up against Titus Worldwide. I'll honestly tell you that I care about the chamber matches as well as the Matt Hardy versus Bray Wyatt feud match. So there's going to be a lot of fast-forwarding going on during the show tonight, but we'll get through it, and we'll talk about it when it's all over. Peace out, everybody.